Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. I got several comments, and not just several. I got over 30 comments, roughly, in the last few days. People that want to do the business but are scared to do the business. And there's several things at play here. Sometimes you just don't, you're not a type A personality, you know, which is probably good. I'm a type A, you know, I shoot first, aim tomorrow. And it gets me in trouble. But I also don't have a lot of risk aversion, which means I don't really care about the risk. I'm just like, I can start over. I've started over before. You know, I didn't have this job before I had this job kind of deal, and I was fine. So I wanted to talk to you about how I understand that to be. And I'll tell you, I was scared to start it because you're going, are people going to stop? Is it going to work? Am I going to make any money? And the truth is that no matter what food business you open, you know, unless you're in a country that doesn't do beef and you're an all beef taco stand, that wouldn't be smart. But if you're in a food business and you give good service, good prices, good quality, you win, period. People will try it, they will like it, and they'll keep coming back. And so I want to, though, counter what happens if you hate it. You hate the business, or you're just like, man, I can't make it. What's the worst that can happen? Well, you could lose $5,000 on a cart and all the time it took to get started. And it'd be a little embarrassing because you told all your friends and family and everybody at church to come see you down there in front of the Piggly Wiggly where you're going to be set up. And I get that. That's nerve-wracking. It's frustrating, and it's a thought you have in the back of your head. The thing that separates the doers from the don't-doers is actually getting out there and doing it. And the people that are successful do it over and over and over, and they failed many times. You're looking at one. So it just happens. We fail typically because we didn't do all our due diligence or something. It's why I created learnhotdogs.com. It's why there's no commercials on my YouTube. It's why I have all the answers you could possibly want at learnhotdogs.com that covers kettle corn, whether you're doing hot dogs or not, covers lemonade, covers it all. And you can search by the topic. My point being is that you can, there's risk in everything. There's risk at Walmart. Walmart could get caught up in some kind of crazy stuff and shut down. Kmart did. TGNY did. Those companies did. Sears. That was a staple for over 100 years. Gone. Basically gone. Do you get a Sears catalog in the mail every year, twice a year? Nope. You know why? Because they're gone. So my point being is that you take the risk. Do it because it is fail-proof. Honestly, the business is fail-proof. The only reason that vending in any shape, form, or fashion is going to fail is if you've said, man, I'll tell you what, people love chitlins in Argentina. Love them. Or in Georgia, okay? I mean, I grew up eating chitlins, but my point is you go try to serve chitlins in Washington State, and they're going to be like, what? Pig guts? I ain't eating no pig guts. So menu, your lack of ability to get off the couch, like you don't have any gumption to go do it, or you get lazy with it and you don't give good food, good quality service. And that covers the food to the cost of the food, you know, what you're selling it for. So you could fail if you don't follow my steps. The bottom line is follow my steps. I'm not a guru, okay? But just follow some simple steps. You will be successful, period. There is no way to fail at it. I've used the paint in the house example or analogy. I could use a million different analogies. I love the digging a hole, okay? A digging a hole is a three-step process, okay? And I'll guarantee you a hole. Get a shovel, stick the shovel in the ground, scoop out the shovel, three steps. You have a hole, period. It never fails. Now, could you dig on stone? Could you go, well, I was trying to dig on my roof or on the back of that four-wheeler. Duh. So follow the steps and you will be successful. Now, will you could you really screw up if you said, you know what, I'm going to open me a brick and mortar store. If this is a good location, I feel good about it. Feel real good about it. I asked everybody at church, all three people, and it's a great place to open a business, and I'm going to do it. And then you find out that they're rerouting the highway because you didn't do enough due diligence, and now you opened a business where there's going to be a city dump next door to you and two, you know, porta potty places. So my point is that you could fail there and fail big. Here, the worst that's going to happen is you decide, I don't want to do these steps. And it's not like they're hidden steps. I tell you them up front. So it's not like you go, well, Ben didn't tell me. I was going to have to get out of the bed. I tell you, I literally tell you that you got to get out of the bed. You got to turn off Jerry Springer and you got to go out there and do something. My point being, I know I've said my point several times. I got lots of points. So I got to do this. I got points. So what I'm saying is that you have to be self-motivated, self-directed, make yourself go do it. I was put in a pinch. I had kids on food stamps. I had a wife that was like, not really, you know, putting on your best foot here. You know, she didn't badger me, but my point is I felt like less of a man, less of a dad, less of a father because I wasn't doing what I could do. So I wasn't going to fail. I was going to win, win, win. Now, I've put all that out there for free. I don't have a course on this planet that the information isn't already free at the blog. So you ain't got to buy no course from me. You ain't got to buy jack crap from me. I put it all out there. I've been saying this for years. But I appreciate you buying a course or appreciate you buying my book. But that's not why I'm here. Okay? So if you'll follow those steps, you will be successful. But is there another way? What if you don't have $5,000 to start or $3,000 to start or $2,000 to start? I have other methods. You can go to learnhotdogs.com/broke, even if you're not broke, and find a less risky option and go, you know what? Ben's on to something. That little hillbilly is, or big, fat, short, fat, bald hillbilly is pretty smart. I'm going to go to his site. And I'm going to pick one of those things, and I'm going to start with lemonade, or I'm going to start with kitchen income. That's kitcheninincome.com, by the way. I'm going to start with one of those. And then I haven't invested more than a couple $100, or I've invested $500, or whatever it is. Some of them have no investment. So other than your time and your energy. And you can take that and grow it. I have followed vendors for years, and over a decade, roughly a decade and a half now, and watched them and filmed it and shown their progress so I could share it with you, so that you could go, dang, if Jennifer can do it, I can do it. If Ben's sisters can do it when they were struggling on food stamps and they decided we're going to start a lemonade business, and the first day made over $500 freaking dollars in the mountains of North Carolina where there ain't but three people live there, and two of those were out of town. I'm just telling you that you can make this business successful just by following steps. There is no luck involved. Luck is great. I love luck. But what I'm saying is there's none of that involved. It's not like you're going to call me up and, Ben, you're a liar. You're a cotton picking, sucking, toe sucking liar. And I'll go, okay, well, I forgot to tell you that you have to have three arms and two noses to get this done. You have to get lucky. No, there's no luck. There's no nothing involved other than you taking the steps that I give you and checking them off and doing that, and you will be successful, period. So fear be damned, okay? Because just get over it. I was that long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. I was scared, okay? Now, I still wasn't like overwhelmed with fear. It didn't prevent me from moving forward. My kids wanted to eat every day, and I wanted to feed them, and I hated being on food stamps because it made me feel crappy. I love the food stamp program. It's for people like me who make stupid decisions, lose their businesses, and now can't feed their kids. I'm thankful that that exists, but I didn't want to stay on it, so I had a goal to get off in 90 days. Took me a while to get off. I did it in 90 days or before, but it was because I did those steps. Now, I had a bunch of learning curves. There wasn't a lot out there that, you know, that pinpointed everything for me. Some people think, oh, I'm going to share that, and then everybody's going to use it, and then there'll be 9 bajillion hot dog carts down my street, and I won't be able to make a dime. That's not how that works. Not all of us are cut out for vending. Not all of us are cut out for key making either, right? When's the last time you watched a video on key making and went and said, you know what, I'm going to make a key making shop. That's a good business right there. You see what I'm saying? There's some people that go that way. There's some people that become astrophysicists. That was my second option. I was either going to be a hot dog vendor or an astrophysicist. You know that's bull crap, right? All right, so I'm only about 22 years shy of schooling to be an astrophysicist. I love you. I hope that you'll take that information and just make the change, add to it, even if you tone it down a bit and go, you know what, we're not going to get that $12,000 or $15,000 or $30,000 food trailer. We're not going to buy a cart that's 10 grand. We're gonna build our cart, okay? I got a website, buildacart.com. Anyway, we're going to do that, and then we're going to be able to get going, and then we're going to be able to move forward and let that pay for our next, right? Buy a used cart, let it pay for the next cart, pay for the Cadillac cart. That's what you do. Or you go, you know what, I'm going to start with a table, a fold-up table. The church is going to loan me, and I'm going to put me a lemon wedger that I bought for $59 off of Amazon and an $89 freaking smasher, and I'm going to get some cups and sugar, and I'm going to sell 50 cups today at $8 a piece. We just had a meeting today. Vendors United does 2 a week, and one of the vendors there, he's gotten big over the years. But and he was talking about his weekend and what he was selling lemonade, small little glass of lemonade for $8 each. $8 each. Got about a dollar in it. Think about that. Think about that. And sold out. So you have this ability. You have it right now. And it'll be here 5 years from now. It'll be here 10 years from now. So you don't got to make a rush decision. You don't have to be like me. Shoot first, aim tomorrow. You don't have to do any of that. I love you. I hope this helps you. I hope it encourages you. I hope it inspires you. I'll talk to you later.